I think there's going to be close to 100 people here today.
Hey everybody, with the Puddle Group, let's take a group picture on the steps there.
With you, that might add a little bit of savoir-faire or je ne sais quoi to the photo. Probably je ne sais quoi, since I really don't know what. So those who are less vertically inclined, if you wouldn't mind being at the bottom, and those who are of additional stature at the top.
Long exposure.
Emma, you're not going to be in the picture?
Come on.
Oh, she's taking an important phone call. Tell Barack he can wait.
People were a little concerned that you would think they were rude if they didn't listen to every word you said because they're so busy snapping away. So that's...
I am just here to serve.
Each tour I've been on has been a little bit different.
Sure.
So,
sign in with Carrie over here. If you haven't signed in, Carrie's right over here in the pink and black vest.
Were a big part of the architecture of the Asian architecture when Mr. and Mrs. Fox opened in the 1920s. They opened theater. It was a silent movie house. This was a movie palace.
Oh.
Elephants are in here. They're over 100 years old. If you'd have walked in that door in 1929, it would look just like it is today. The only thing is they had a golden chenille carpet on the floor. Well, after a couple of years, the chenille wore out, so we just had the original terrazzo floor. And you know, our weather in St. Louis isn't so good, so when we redid the lobby several years ago, we had to carpet it for safety reasons, because we're in a freestanding building and with a slanted lobby. Only two, three are left is St. Louis, Detroit, and Atlanta. So if you're ready to go on up to the third floor, this carpet is cut so that the elephants are always facing the stage. So if you ever get lost and you wonder where the stage is, just follow the elephants.
Look at these drinking fountains. They are original and they still work. Aren't they ornate? And there is our glass above it. So you want to take a picture, have someone taking a drink of water out of the... And when Mary Poppins was here, she flew from the stage to right here. And one of them is the size, some of them are the size of a pencil and some of them are about this big.
It's getting small enough.
So you was think of you of 1929 and you'd see just what you see today.
And without television at that time, it would have been even more awestruck because they were so unused to seeing.
They don't make buildings like this anymore.
They don't.
And see this here, it's like a tent. See, they had the sun in the middle. They got the blue skies. You can see the tent posts that are hanging out. And it's plaster, it's molded like... you know, tents were made out of some sort of material, and so the plaster's, and then they say there's like something that's over the plaster, and you can see all the detail in the ceiling. Look at the stenciling and everything. She was a world traveler, and she did a lot. She was over in India a lot, and this is her. She was in charge of the interior, so he did the building, and she was in charge of the interior. And then when it was purchased by Fox Associates, Mary Strauss is in charge of the interior, and she wanted to bring it back to its original splendor, which I think she did.
And how long was it a movie theater?
It was a movie theater until it closed in 1978.
Really?
Wow. And then it opened once or twice in 79 for one or two nights, and then it closed for good. And then it was purchased in the spring of 81, and it reopened September 7th, 1982. Leon Strauss, he was a neighborhood rehabber, and he called Mary one day, his wife, and says, I'm going to the Fox, you want to come along? They was touring the Humboldt building next door, which is kind of connected. And there was no one light in the whole building, there was bats flowing, and he says, they were going to tear this down and make a parking lot. And he says, she says, you can't do it. We got to save it. And he says, I'm a neighborhood rehabber. I'm not a theater rehabber. But she nagged him and nagged him and nagged him. And he got a group of men together. They formed a partnership and they purchased it. So this is privately owned. And kids, when you come in and you tell them this was a movie theater, it was 5,060 seats. And they said, did they fill it? Because you know the movie theaters today are, what, 100 seats?
Yeah.
And one time they had a party for us at Bevo Mill, and they had all these vacuum cleaners, and this one girl says, Tommy, they cleaned the place, but they didn't remove the vacuum cleaner. Well, that was our entertainment. And he had one that you had to move like this to get it to work. And he was a gadget collector. He had all kinds of gadgets. And he played here on Saturday. They had something on the Grand, and they had the Fox open. He played here on Saturday. He played Sunday over in Illinois, and he went to the hospital Sunday night and died Monday. If you want, you can go through Peacock Alley. You can look on the stage. That used to be Eve Leo's art gallery. We don't have the stuff she had, and we just had pictures of the different artists. But on the 25th anniversary of the reopening, they took and made a panel of each what each show was that year. And if you've ever been here and seen our jeweled curtain, that is a companion piece. And it used to be the jeweled curtain was down a lot before the shows, but now all the different shows are bringing in their own curtains, so we don't know. This is called Peacock Alley because if you notice, there's a peacock at each end. First time Katz was here, I didn't care for it. It was so slow. And everybody said they fall asleep. But the second time and the other time, they pepped it up and the cats were tap dancing. And I worked downstairs. And when the cats would come up from downstairs, you could see them. I could be as close to you and you could see all their makeup. And they would just move just like they did on stage. They almost looked like really cats. And then the kids, you know, like I said, did they fill it? Well, you didn't have TV. You didn't have iPhones. You didn't have none of that stuff. You went to the show. Once we were kids, we went to the neighborhood show. We could walk. we'd pay a quarter. And then as we got older, we could come here, and we went to and working and paying our own way. Well, then we could come up here to, we could come from work. We'd take the streetcar.
So this room looks pretty much like it did when the Fox first opened. The furnishings in here are original furnishings that Eva Leo Fox went out and purchased for the Fox. She spent $700,000 to see to it this place was properly appointed when it opened. 1928, yes. Yeah. Underneath the stairs here, we have three nice telephone booths. They've long since have had the telephones removed. They used to have a nice curved handle on it, and at least twice they've been stolen out of here. The potty room here used to have potties just on the one wall, and they added them to the second wall. Over here was a powder room, and there used to be a doorway there through into the powder room, and they converted that into a potty room also. And they had the nurse's office back in there, and they put potties in that. They've done all that, and still the line goes up the stairs at intermission.
Oh, yeah.
And there's two things I found came into play. One, I've seen pictures of movie audiences from the late 20s, and it's over 90% men. Second, there was an aversion to using public restrooms at the time, and people have gotten over that completely. The carpet in here, they were going to reproduce the original one, and they found out what it would cost to set up looms to weave it. And they said, well, this is similar. This is nice. And so this is what we've got in the ladies' lounges. I've even seen a picture of a movie studio or a theater from 1915 or so, and it said tickets 25 cents.
Wow.
Balcony 10 cents. Okay, so rather than having that disparity, they have all one price tickets by the time they got to this theater, and they put in these nice staircases to entice people to go upstairs and utilize the balcony. It has to lead someplace good if it's that nice a staircase, doesn't it? So it worked. Any rate, here in the arches that we came through, we have some draperies. There were draperies all over this place, or the only ones left. And then you have a little face underneath there that I really like. Someone that only Dr. Spock could love, with his big pointy ears here. These nice columns with the American Eagle on them are all Hollywood stuff. They're hollow plaster. And the marbling was painted by Italian artisans in a process they call scagola. The lobby here is 90 feet long, 50 feet wide, 60 feet up to the ceiling there. When they were refurbishing it, this half of the ceiling had been painted over because of water damage, and the other half was peeling. And after it had been open for about 10 years, Mary finally got her way, and they went up there and they traced what was left of the pattern, reproduced it, and we had the 4 points section there again. So 2011, they had strung a rubberized fabric above it to take care of any drips that came through the roof, see to it that it stayed off there. 2011, one April morning, it decided to burn. And it filled this whole place with smoke. They struck 3 alarms just to get the manpower here to search this place and find out where the smoke was coming from. When they found it, the fire department did what they do best. They wet it down good. And there was water just streaming out the front doors coming down. And like I said, everything you're looking at is plaster. All of it was over 80 years old. And it didn't like being wet. So they spent all summer of 2011 with scaffolding up to the ceiling, repairing not just the pattern part of the ceiling, but also a lot of this other plaster work was damaged, and they had to take molds off of good parts and remold pieces and put them up there. But the place is looking good now. But at any rate, they did a thorough cleaning of the theater at the time. And they cleaned all the seats. They had scaffolding in this inside going all the way to the lighting alcove on the side walls. And they cleaned everything but the ceiling of the auditorium. It has been dusted once when they were getting ready to reopen in the 80s. And that is the only time that it's been touched. This summer, we're going to be set down for 6 weeks, and they're going to clean the ceiling and refurbish it. We have the lions here, and then you have these sea monsters here. You're going to see the same figures lining the sides of the balcony upstairs as these monsters that we've got lining the side walls here. Virtually all the other artwork in here, it's not really meant to be interpreted so much as each time you come, you see new and interesting things you hadn't seen before. They had a nice chenille carpet in here when the place opened. And if any of you came here during the movie days, you remember a big county candy counter in here, served off of all four sides of it. Well, that sort of tacky thing was not part of the original Fox. It was something that was added in the 30s. Theaters were adding them in because during the Depression they had to do what they could to make a few dollars and get it to maybe a business success.
Now you can see what the artists see when you go. Tony Orlando was the first one, and then Rita Moreno signed it. Then there's the Bob Hope, Steve Skinos, right here. Here's Sammy Davis Jr. Here's the first one to sign,
Sammy and Jen. Jen.
Get a tour
of the base camp. That's right.
Take the time to say a whole series of one.
But originally, this was a movie house. And the people that owned the movies, and the people that owned the theaters, they would bring their movies in here. And show them to the theater owners to see what movies they wanted to show in their theater. So this is what it was for then. And then they thought maybe it was a rehearsal hall. But what we use it for now is we're all volunteers. And before each show, we have an hour and a half before each show, we have a meeting. And they tell us the running times, the house count, any hold, and anything that we might need to pertain to the show. But they will be announcing the new season, they said, sometime in April. But we have all kinds of shows there. Just check the website. Saturdays, there is an organ concert beforehand. So thank you very, very much.
Thank you very much.
I hope you got lots of pictures. And as we go out this door here, you can see the antique projectors.
They were going to have a graffiti tour where they just did graffiti.
Oh.
They haven't arranged that yet.
I haven't seen any of the graffiti.
Well, you can't imagine how much of that there is. And they were thinking about doing an architectural tour where you got to go up and see some of the architecture.
Oh, that'd be nice.
That's tough. Let's see how sharp it is. There is a sharp. It won't be a sharp. It's a
single. It's going to merge.
It's merging three. Right. So it's one thing.
So it will get to the right.
Just like everybody else has to color pencil. Go just an online.